Hello everyone, I am Dr. Vijay. Today we will discuss about training methods. This lecture is in continuation to our previous lecture on training and its process. The major outcome of the lecture are, after taking this lecture, you should be able to understand different on-the-job training methods, off-the-job training methods, and simulation in detail. You'll also be able to explain how and where to use different training methods. Okay, let's move to the training methods. There are three broad training methods which includes as, the first one is on-the-job training, second is off-the-job, and third one is the simulation. In off-the-job training, we refer certain methods as coaching, job rotation, committee assignment, action learning, apprenticeship, etc. Off-the-job training includes lectures, case study, role-playing, business games, etc. Okay. In part one of our training methods, we'll discuss about on-the-job training methods. Rest we'll discuss in part two of the training methods. Okay. Let's learn different methods one by one. On-the-job training means having a person learn a job while working on it. Please understand, our concern in on-the-job training is that the person will learn the skills required to perform a job while working on it. Okay, that the person is learning the skills while working on it. That's the key to the on-the-job trainings. The key features of on-the-job training, or as we abbreviated it as OJT in our last lecture, it is usually given by senior employee or immediate supervisor. Okay, and the second thing is the second thing that we observe as a key feature of OJT is that the trainee is shown how to perform the job and allowed to do it under the trainee's supervision. Or we can say that the new trainee does productive work during the learning process, and the best thing is that we can have the quick feedback on their performances. Okay, the third key feature is that there is no need of expensive off-site facilities for conducting the training. In the picture below, you can see a newcomer or a trainee in red outfits working under the supervision of immediate supervisor at a construction site. Now we have coaching and job rotation. Coaching is a one-on-one process that enables employees' development and improved performance. Okay, in coaching, at first, the coach shall assess the personality traits of the participant. The first thing that needs to be done in coaching is the coach shall assess the personality traits of the participants and how do they handle the various situations. Need to understand that what is their view about the different situation, how they are going to act or react in a particular situation. The two things needs to be understood well by the coach. This assessment creates association with employees to establish goals and action plans until the goals are achieved. Now, see, what is the purpose to assess the personality and how they are handling the situation is so that the coach very good association in between, and we could achieve the goals or the action plans that are expected for which the coaching is being conducted. The major type of coaching involves coaching for skills, coaching for performance, coaching for an executive agenda. In coaching, to understand coaching for skills, let's take an example. An employee does not know how to perform the process correctly, any process correctly, that may be because of lack of skills, lack of knowledge, or certain abilities which are required to perform a process. In that case, a specific coaching to learn a trait will be provided to him. Okay, clear? That What is needed is that to complete a process, certain skills, knowledge or abilities are needed. A coaching for those skills, abilities and knowledge being provided so that the process could be carried correctly and efficiently. Okay. However, in case of coaching for performance, we see if an employee is not able to perform to its highest level, maybe because of improper procedure, maybe because of lack of resources, or maybe because of lack of motivation, etc. In that case, we try to remove the problem to enhance the performance. Okay. So basically saying, if there are lack of resources, what we'll do is we'll bring in the resources. If there is a lack of motivation, motivational coaching will be provided. If the procedures are not clearly laid down and there is a confusion in between, we'll try to lay down or will help an individual understand what does these procedure means. Okay. So thereby we could have the different coachings for the performance. Similarly, in coaching for an executive agenda, specific agendas or problems areas are taken and are being worked on. Okay. Then we have job rotation. It is a systematic process. Job rotation is a systematic process which is used to shift employees from one job to another. And why this shifting from one job to another is done? Why? Okay, the purpose to shift one person from one job to another in job rotation is to make them familiar with all the verticals of an organization. Okay, so that one is able to understand and carry on the things properly, and they shall also understand the importance of other works that being carried into our organization. The major objectives are as under. The first one is to enhance work experience and job satisfaction. And the second is to select employees for their right places. Then we have the types of job rotation. We see task rotation and position rotation. Let's understand these two. In task rotation, the employees who are working on mentally stressful jobs or physically demanding job, they are usually given a task rotation. And what we do is we shift these employees from stressful jobs to less demanding jobs to provide a break from routine work. Okay. So hum log basically what we are doing is from mentally stressful or physically demanding, wheresoever we have such jobs, in those jobs we put them on to other jobs where there is less of stress, and hence they'll be relaxed for the time being. In case of position rotation, the designation, location or department of the employee is changed. Thereby, an opportunity is given to the employee to gain different skills, knowledge and new work perspective. Okay. Further, position rotation has two types, namely cross-functional rotation. We are concerned with position rotation right now. These are two types. The first is cross-functional rotation and second is function rotation. Okay. During cross-functional rotation, the level and job responsibilities of the employees are changed. While under function rotation, the responsibility and areas of operation of employees remains the same. Okay, let me repeat again. Position rotation has two types, namely cross-functional rotation and function rotation. During cross-functional rotation, the level and job responsibility of the employees are changed, while under function rotations, the responsibility and area of operation remains the same. Okay. Other OGT methods are we have committee assignments and action learning. In committee assignment, the organization conducts regular meeting or seminar of employees where they get a real or current problem of the organization as an assignment. And they are supposed to provide an appropriate workable solution. Okay. Committee assignments usually leads to teamwork and leadership qualities into the trainees. Okay, so this way we carry on with the committee assignments. Another OJT method is action learning. It is a training technique by which management trainees are allowed to work full time in analyzing and solving the problem from other department. Okay, the action learning program work in the manner. At first, what we do is we carefully select team of 5 to 25 members. Okay, where 5 is the minimum number and 25 is the maximum number. These teams are then assigned real world problem, and the problem are of the extent that is beyond their usual area of expertise. Okay, got the idea that they'll be assigned real world problem, and the problem will be of the extent that they are beyond their usual area of expertise. Okay, simultaneously, a structured learning through coaching and feedback is carried. So this is how the action learning has been done. Hope action learning is clear till now. Further, in action planning, usually the top managers selects the project and decides whether to accept the recommendation or not to accept the recommendation received from this method. Sometime it has also been observed that while carrying on the succession planning, action planning or action learning method being used to see that in unusual condition or where a higher level of expertise is needed, who all are the individuals or the employees who could take on the situation in best possible way. This is also being used by some of the companies to carry on their succession planning. Okay, now see, committee assignments, we have discussed right now the committee assignment and action learning. Committee assignments, when carried in more formalized way, they are also called as action learning. Okay, got the idea? So the action learning is more formalized one, and this is not the formalized one. Let's move to our last on the job training, that is apprenticeship. It is one of the oldest form of training. The new employee is appointed as an apprentice. Apprenticeship training is the most common in skilled workers. Like as reflected in the picture, a doctor and his apprentice. Similarly, for electricians, machine men, plumbers, etc., they learn their job through such learning. In this, the trainee is placed under the charge of a qualified senior worker, and he or she learns the methods of work by observing and assisting his senior. The period of apprenticeship may be different from job to job. It may be anything between 1 to 5 years. During apprenticeship, the worker is paid less salary than a trained worker. Okay, we are winding up our part one of training methods. Hope you enjoyed the lecture. See you soon in part two of the training method. Thanks for patience learning. Thank you.